Zeal Education Society, redefining excellence.
Everyone must have a will to win, dreams to come true. If we want to experience success, we have to be prepared. We all have the ability to create what we want in life, but do we have the power to act on the ability we possess? When we are confident and can act on our ability, then the magic starts. Opportunities come in. We all have an invisible energy which guides us when we take the bold step. It definitely happens. We realize that all forces around us will turn supportive. So get started, and all your dreams will come true. It becomes real. So now I'm going to talk about myself. First of all, I believe in giving respect to our own self. Unless then, others are not going to respect us. So I take you all, maybe rewind 30, 35 years back. I was in my teens. I was the first born in my family, the apple of the eye of my parents, pampered. And I belong to a very conservative family, but I was very much pampered and I had a very lovely life. I had a sister and a brother. It all happened when I was in my teens, just like any other young person, most of us, I think. I fell in love. Sorry, I'm not here debating whether we can fall in love and get married, but I fell in love and got married. And my marriage was a disaster. I had committed a mistake which I was not able to alter it. And I was on the crossroads. I was not like supported by both the sides, both my in-laws and my parents. They did not want to have anything to do with me. So I had brought myself to it and I had nobody else to blame. And this was the time when I had to take a call, whether I live or die. So even before I could realize that, even before I could think, okay, now it's over, let me escape this life, I realized that I was pregnant and I had a child. I was going to have a child. So my priorities changed. I had to change my priorities. And I said, I'm going to live for my child. And how am I going to live? What was I going to do? I was just 19 years. I didn't know what I was to do. And that time I just thought like nobody's going to give me a job. And only thing I could fall back on was my hobby. My hobby was cooking. I loved cooking. It was my passion. So whatever we want to do, like if we have a passion, I think we all will be successful. And that is how I started. I started in a very small way. I started doing some jams, squashes, and pickles. And of course, it did get sold. Luck also was on my side. It got sold, but I did not have a commercial kitchen. Mine was a household kitchen, and I was not able to make that much produce. So what next? I was trying to think of that. And that was a time when my father's friend, he offered me a small kiosk. These kiosks, 30 years back, were not selling anything else. They were only selling some cigarettes or coffee and tea. But then I chose a place that, I don't know how many of you know Chennai. The beach there is called Marina. And in the evenings, it's infested with people. So I chose that place and I thought I can have that kiosk there. I did not know that we have to go in for prior permissions from the government and all that. I just thought I can go and place my kiosk there and start off my business. But then when I went there, people said you have to go to the secretariat and get the permission. So secretariat, I did not know. I was so naive. I did not know what it was. So I just went to secretariat carrying my child with me. He was just about 1.5 years old then. I took him and when I went there and I found that the secretariat, the PWD department is on the 10th floor. I was so scared. I did not take the lift. I walked all the 10 stairs up And only thing in my mind is, I have to do this. I have to get this done. And only that was there. So my focus was only that. And I walked all these stairs. And when I went there, this PWD secretary's secretary, she would not allow me to meet him. She said, I need to have a permission or some recommendation. Then again, it was a halt. I did not know what to do. I went there every day and sat in his room, only thinking that one day this man will see me and ask who this lady is. And it did happen. And then he called me inside, and I told him this is what happened. He was very nice. That time, things were looking very nice, like it was very easy. He called his subordinates, and they told me that I should be given permission to run the kiosk there. But after that, it took almost a year for me to get that done because things were not moving that fast. But still, I got the place, I got the kiosk, I got the permission, and I put my kiosk there. And it was a Friday evening, and I had all sorts of things in my kiosk, like we wouldn't even think of. I had French fries, I had cutlets, I had samosas, which nobody was selling on those days. People were coming, looking at us, looking at me, and then walking off. And the first day's sale, you all won't even guess, it was one cup of coffee, which was sold for 50 paisa. I just sold a cup of coffee on the first day for 50 paisa. I think this would be more than enough to pull anybody to the dumps. I was heartbroken. I went home, and I needed somebody to... I wasn't going to come back the next day because I had given up all hopes. Then it was my mom. She said, no, you're going to do it. It is going to be successful. And the next day again, I went. And from there, it was no turning back. Things were going on very well. Like, people ask me, what is your education? What have you done? So I very proudly say, I've done my MBA. But where, which university? I say it is my kiosk at the marina. I have learned all the nuances of my business in that place. But then that was not sufficient. Like, it was only in the evenings. Then from there on, I started looking for other catering contracts. I was doing government catering, bank catering, and all that. But my breakthrough was I had taken up a catering contract at the National Institute of Port Management, which I had to serve for about 1,500 to 2,000 people in a day. So when I went there to meet the chairman, he just told me, bluntly told me that this was not a housewife's job. And he said, this is not a lady's job. I felt very insulted. Why I'm specifically telling this is, I said, when we think we want something, that invisible energy in us pushes to get that. So that with that insult, I came back. But every day I started saying that I need to get into this place. And in a matter of 3 months, I got a call from that place. The so-called male caterer had ditched them and he walked out. So they had to come back to me take up their catering. And in 2 days' time, I did take up, and then there was no looking back. Everything was very fine. I was feeling very nice, flying in the ninth cloud. By then, my son had grown up. My daughter had grown up. My personal life was a disaster. I need not say about it. Whatever we hear and see in movies and all that, everything was happening in my personal life. So I'm not exaggerating or I'm not talking about it. But my business and my children, they were growing up. I was very happy. And everything was going on very well. I got my son married in 2002. He was also sailing. I put him in the same Merchant Navy College. He was sailing, and my daughter had finished her graduation. Everything was wonderful. Everybody was talking about me. They said, a single woman, a single parent, you've done your duties very well. Lot of friends, and everything was going on very well. But again, things stuck me so badly. That was in 2004. I got my daughter married. She was married on April 29th. And exactly 30 days after her marriage, she was coming back to Chennai from Dindukal, a place in Chennai, the south. She met with an accident. It was a head-on collision, and I lost both my son and daughter. I lost both my son-in-law and my daughter in the accident. just before this accident happened, 15 minutes before that, she had spoken to me. And the next call was that they were no more. So what is life? Finally, it is only death which succeeds. But then I had no time to think of anything. I had to rush to that place, which was about 2 hours from where I was. I reached the hospital, the government hospital, and when nobody was there, nobody knew what was happening. And after some time, 2 ambassador cars came, and they pulled my children out of the boots of the cars. And when I asked them why, they said that they don't carry dead people in ambulances, which I heard for the first time, and I wouldn't want even my worst enemy to see something like that. But then after that, I was really down. I had lost all hopes on life, and I thought everything is over, like my life is done, and I have nothing more to even look. And that was the time I realized that people who were around me, I saw true people. I mean, a lot of people who were there with me were just thinking that I will have a downfall and I'm not going to get out of it. People were asking me, will you even survive this? Things were so bad. I had no help from anybody. It was only my son and my family who were standing by me. My son had quit his sailing, and my business, I was doing very good business, and my business was all crumbling. And it was my son who pulled it up, and he was also very new to the business. He didn't know what to do. He was trying to pull up the strings what I had dropped. He left his job, and he stood with me. Until today, he is with me in business. I should thank him for that. And I thought, that is the end of everything, and I'm not going to get up from this great blow. But slowly, I started realizing, after about 2-3 years, I was really not coming out of the house. But then I started realizing that things are not going to be that easy. I have to fight it out, because it is not that we decide whether we live or die. And I was my sole counselor. I did not have any professional help. I pulled myself up and I started asking questions. Why me? Why God has done this to me? Why have you done this to me, God? But then these questions, we never get answers. Never in our life we are going to get answers. But one thing is, I started understanding that when things were good, none of us questioned God. We don't ask God, why have you given me so many good things in life? Why are we getting so much of blessings? But when things go bad, immediately we start questioning, why me? Why this is happening to me? So I stopped all that and I said, now I have something to do. And that was the time when FICCI honored me with the Women Entrepreneur Award. So that gave me a lot of realization. I said, okay, I realized that I have achieved something. There are things which I have done and people are recognizing it. So I said, okay, now I have to pull myself up and I have to do something. And that is the time we started building up our business. And my son wanted to start his restaurant. And again, on his her sister's name, he started my restaurant called Sandeepa. And we are running it successfully now. So this is how we started our restaurant. I do a lot of corporate catering as well. But then that ambulance thing, what happened is, I wanted to have an ambulance in that place where my daughter passed away. So I have an ambulance running in that place from 2004 till now. We have served about 3,000 victims so far, both dead and alive. We serve them. I mean, at least the dead people, I see to it that they are taken to the nearest hospital with little bit of respect. But this is what is happening. Somebody said something? Yeah, okay. So this is what happens. And why I'm sharing all this is, like, it is not that easy a job. Like, even till today, I will not say I'm successful. I've reached heights of success. I'm not a veteran. I'm just an amateur entrepreneur. every day I just tell myself, I have to learn and I'm still learning. And when I come to places like this to talk to people, I wish to at least inspire one person. When I tell you my sad story and present myself in front of you, people at least feel, okay, we can come out of grief and this is how we can be successful. So I share my story here so that I can at least inspire one of you, one person from this crowd. At the end, all of us, our lives are all stories. So let us make it a very beautiful story. Thank you.
Zeal Education Society, redefining excellence.